I want to ask you the same question. Your prophet was for 40 years doing what? Because he became a prophet after the age of 40. So 40 years he was living like an animal. And actually the Quran says that Muhammad for 40 years of his life, he did not know even what faith mean, which means he was living like a cow. But according to your Quran, Jesus was a prophet of God even when he was a child. Even when he was a child, he was teaching wisdom. Let me show you. We go to Yusuf Ali and we read the following. When they came to Mary, you know, and in here there's a mistake in the story, because Muhammad, he misunderstood the name of Mary, the sister of Aaron, the sister of Moses and Aaron, with Mary, the mother of Jesus. This is how liar he is. Anyway, and here you will see that when they came to Mary to talk to her, she pointed her finger to the cradle, to the child in the cradle. But here we go, surprisingly, Mr. Abdul, your God saying that Jesus spoke in the cradle, speaking wisdom in an immature way. He is an immature, which means he is from the first second of his birth, he is a prophet and messenger of God in your Quran. But in the same time, in your stories about your prophet, he was for 40 years nothing, because he became a prophet after the age of 40. After the age of 40, your prophet, he became a messenger of Allah. So for 40 years he was what? If we go to the Quran, we will see that for 40 years Muhammad was an infidel. Let us read chapter 42, verse number 52. Not my translation, read with me. Let us teach the Abdul how to behave. Read, Abdul, please. Chapter 42, verse number 52. And thus have we by our command sent inspiration to thee who Muhammad, which he knew nothing totally about revelation. And he knew nothing about faith. So your prophet, he did not know what faith mean and what revelation mean. So he was a pagan. And that proved a lie when Muslim they say that Muhammad, he was following the steps of Abraham. Because if he followed the steps of Abraham, it means he knew, he have faith, for he believed in the God of Abraham. But in here it says you do not know even what faith mean, and you do not know what revelation mean, which means he never ever have any revelation about any prophet. Because if Abraham says God is one and let us worship this God, this is a revelation from God. He is not speaking for his own. But the Quran saying Muhammad, he have no revelation, he had never heard of it, and he have no faith. He was a communist maybe. So we have to go by the Quran. So for 40 years your prophet was living like a cow in this earth, doing nothing but having sex and eating and doing poo-poo. But in your Quran, Jesus spoke in the cradle as a wise, the wisdom and the word of God. And that actually prove who is Jesus, because the one who speak in the cradle, it's mean he never been taught. Because here we go, when the angel came to him to teach him, when he was in his mother womb, that proved the story of the Christian, that Jesus, when he said before Abraham I am, which means he was exist before his birth. The birth is just a new stage of Jesus coming to us in a form and a person of a man. But Christ, the word of God, is always exist. This is why Jesus, I said, I am the Alpha, I am the Omega. So in here we answer those Muslims, the dummy, who tried to downgrade Jesus because he have the body of a man. But in the same time, the hypocrite, they forgot that their Quran saying that Jesus is holy, as we showed you in chapter 19, verse 19. Their Quran saying that Jesus is perfect, because even he can create from the mother bird. Their Quran is saying is the one who create the same as the one who create not, which means Allah, he put a standard for God, that the one who is God is the one you should worship, and the one who you should worship is the one who create, and that is Jesus, because the Quran is saying that he is a creator. In the same time, Muslims, they try to downgrade Jesus for having a body of a man, but they forgot that the one who brought the most holy thing to them, supposedly, is the Spirit of Allah. And we showed you how the Spirit of Allah appeared to Mary as a perfect man. And we, if we ask the Muslims, the Spirit of Allah who appeared to Mary as a perfect man, he have a penis, does that mean he is not holy no more? Is that to change his nature, that spirit? They will say no. And this is the Spirit of Allah, remember, which means it's Allah, because Allah and his Spirit should be one, unless this is theirs to Allah. So Allah's Spirit having a penis is not a problem for the Muslims, but Jesus having a look of a man, it's a problem. In the same time, their God Allah is saying, if I want to have a son, I have to have find a girlfriend. And if I want a girlfriend, I'm going to have sex with my with the angels and the Huri. I know the Huris, they have vagina, but I don't know how the angels, Allah is going to have sex with them. Is the angels of Allah males or females? It's just a question, because I'm trying to find out how Allah is going to have sex, because the example is really stupid, showing me the stupidity of Muslims. At the same time, the Muslims believe that Allah is a physical being. He have a leg, he have a hand, he have a face. If you are saying to me that Allah is assless, well, may Allah ask you, this is not my problem. Do you have a proof that Allah is not assless, like he don't have an ass? You don't. Do you have a proof that Allah don't have a penis? You don't. You cannot even talk about it, because you do not know. You cannot deny it, and you cannot accept it, because simply you go only by what is written. And what is written? Allah have hands, Allah have face. As long as he have a face, it means he have a back. As long as he have a hand, it means he have the same look as anybody. He's a creature, you know. Simply, when Jesus came, you know, when God came to us in the look of Jesus, that did not downgrade God, because God, the way he is not like a man. Our God is not a man, but we see that your God in here is just a man. And actually, before we finish, we need to remember a hadith, very important one. In Sahih al-Bukhari, it says the following. In Sahih al-Bukhari, book number 55, hadith number 649, Muhammad saying that the false Messiah, he have a bad eye, a damaged eye, and that is the right eye, as you see with me. But your God Allah, so this is what, this is a person who will come as a false Messiah, the Antichrist. But look, Muhammad saying Allah is not one-eyed. What does that mean? It's mean Allah have full two eyes, the same as the real Messiah. And here actually you will see Muhammad exposing Islam again, because the topic is the Dajjal, the false Messiah. So why he is comparing the false Messiah with Allah? If the false Messiah will look like a man, because simply he is going to take, he will claim to be the Messiah. Therefore he must be, you know, coming as a man. But look what Muhammad saying, the only difference between Allah and the false Messiah is one eye. It's mean the rest of it is the same. It's mean he have a penis, he have an ass, he have knee, he have legs, he have face, he have nose, he have mouth. It's exactly the same as a man, because the false Messiah, he will come in the look of a man, trying to fool us, supposedly, according to the story of Islam, that he is the real Messiah. But what we see from Muhammad in here, that there's only one difference between them. It is just the right eye, the right eye. Allah is not one eye. Allah have two eyes, the same as any man. The false Messiah, this is how you differentiate between them according to Islam. So here we go, you know, again, you're a prophet saying that Allah, he looked the same as the Messiah. Actually, I believe that the whole idea of Islam to hijack the name of the Messiah and to replace the name of the Messiah by the false God of Islam, which is Allah. And this story in here prove it, because here we go, Muhammad replacing the two person to compare with, which supposedly to be the real Messiah and the false Messiah, between Allah and the false Messiah. And the fact, I believe it strongly, that your God Allah is presenting as an idea, not a person, because he doesn't exist, presenting an Antichrist idea. I hope you guys, you enjoyed this video, Christ is Lord. And don't forget to get my book to learn more about Islam. It's called The Deception of Allah. You can get it from Amazon.com, and you can send it as a gift for somebody you know or somebody you love, so nobody can deceive them about Islam. Christ is Lord, Islam is false, and Allah maybe have more than one penis, as we showed you. Maybe. Maybe he don't have any. Maybe. Maybe he is. Maybe.